watered this main motocross track, and then like 30 minutes went by and they watered it again, and it's way overwatered both times, so I'm kind of biding my time. So it's not super slippery, but I think we're probably gonna head out there and maybe do a lap or two. That's kind of interesting. The tree grew like around that pole. Actually, I was gonna. Oh.
Oh,
was quick. All right, we're switch bikes. So Neil's on the old Noble Steed, and I'm on his Ripper. See how it goes. That more if you want.
This thing is set up for this track.
Yeah, it really is.
It's just like the clutch is one finger.
No, it's a good bike. You can
the
do
front,
more.
It's like super stable.
Go do more.
What?
Go do more laps.
Yeah,
I might go do that track on this and just scoop around.
What? What's left? Okay.
This bike and this track do not get along.
That guy's so fast.
This guy is incredibly fast, yeah. Dude, there's been a couple of times where I just cleared the flat to the first bump, like Baggett style, and I'm just like, okay, I'm the shit.
I
want
to see how he takes this wheel.
Good enough. I'm not used to the controls quite as well.
There's a weird sound that comes out of it. Do you hear it? It's like a hissing.
Not really.
How do you not notice it? I just noticed it when you're going up.
Okay, move
your foot. Yeah, it definitely works better on the drive stuff. But it's gonna be kind of front end heavy.
Yeah.
So your bike on the sand track was just the highlight.
It's so good. It's really fun.
Sand track was where I really shined today.
Yep. For like three laps.
Three laps at a time. I got on your bike and did like five laps.
I know. My bike is butter, dude.
Yeah.
Alright, well, thanks for watching, everyone.
Peace.